Saraswati
Deaf and Dumb School, which is managed by Saraswati Badir Education Trust, was established in 1982.
Deaf and dumb children cannot get education as normal students do. Methods to train them are very different. When child comes first to school, they doesn't know his name even. Normal children get training starts with alphabet, but this child's training starts with his own name, later on his mother's and father's and village's name are taught. Later on, the vocabulary of the vegetables, flowers, fruits, and is developed in a group.
Disabled children cannot listen. Normal children used to listen and learn words from family from childhood. But for these children, it is hard to understand words, and so we use pictures to teach them.
To these students, we train them using pictures. They cannot listen or speak, so picture is medium.
If we use VR, we can train them about actions like walk, run, jump. They can learn faster.
Here, when we show virtual reality lessons, means 3D scenes, means dinosaur, shape, fish, animal. We show all these in VR. We show them working of digestive system, how it is in human, in animal. All these they have seen, their expression were very different, astonishing. They see and say, wow, they felt this better than normal run. They can enjoy learning with this technology. Even teachers said that using this technology, their student can be taught fast. Using normal tools, they face many difficulties. Using real-life feeling, they understand easily. They don't need much explanation.
We saw the theoretical concept but don't have practical facilities, but in VR smart class it's really helpful. And in this fotonVR tools you have covered NCERT syllabus that we should shown to children, and they enjoyed it, they liked it.
Today we are at Mukbadir School. Here we have taken students to virtual tour of farm and show them different educational content in VR. By this visit, we have understood in their daily routine of study, they see only pictures or videos. Instead of this, when they use 360 degree VR content, they feel real world, like they feel like they are in the actual farm and seeing crop, how farmers work, etc. Like this, they understand in depth.
They give skills learned training, but our children are trained differently as they are deaf and dumb.
Today, in this school, students are introduced to new technology. From experience of students, I believe they have understood a lot. For them, it was impossible to learn all this. Normal children can go out and learn by visiting places and talking with others. But these children can understand only what is easy. We cannot give such experience on daily basis described by just actions, cannot show them. But using VR, they can learn by watching closely, felt going near to it. From this experience, I believe if we adopt this VR in technology, we can give them what is not provided. To unprivileged can be advantage to be capable of learning. If such technology is used in each field, mainly in education, and for this unprivileged, deprived, if used, I believe these children can benefit it much more than normal children can. What they have missed for what they are not capable of understood or see. They see in virtual world. We can motivate them to know and learn more. And many topics of syllabus cannot be taught to the students. Abstract concept, intangible objects, feelings can be described in VR. I hope such experiments can be conducted in each school. All schools start to use VR technology, then Gujarati and Indian deaf and dumb children can tune with world and compete to survive well. I urge all educationalists to know and understand this technology. Even to education organizations and government, I suggest and request to find out a way to provide this VR technology in each school of deaf and dumb.